Question: How often does President Trump talk about IQ? Answer: All the time. When Mr. Trump recently boasted that his IQ was higher than Secretary of State Rex Tillerson's, it was part of a pattern. In 2013, he tweeted that his IQ was much higher than Barack Obama and George W. Bush. He has also claimed a higher IQ than comedian Jon Stewart, and British star of The Apprentice, Lord Sugar. Despite this, Mr. Trump has never revealed his own IQ, so, can we work it out? @garo34, @realDonaldTrump. Not only is your IQ somewhere between Barack Obama and G.W. Bush, but you're entertaining. Much higher than both. End of Twitter post by @realDonaldTrump. An intelligence quotient is a score given to someone after taking an intelligence test. There is no single IQ test. Mensa accepts results from more than 200 tests, including its own. Some tests last an hour, while some have no time limit. Dr. Frank Lawless, the supervisory psychologist of American Mensa, says they usually test spatial, quantitative, and verbal skills. Broadly, spatial questions are about shape and measurement, quantitative questions are mathematical, and verbal questions are about words, for example, how one word is similar to another. Mensa accepts those who score in the top 2%. That equates, very roughly, to an IQ of 130. More, Bears, Edgers, Zipper. Answers are shown below. I don't recall ever coming across a list of presidents and their IQs, says Dr. Barbara Perry, Director of Presidential Studies at the University of Virginia. But you can easily find a list of presidents inducted into Phi Beta Kappa in their universities. Founded in 1776, Phi Beta Kappa honors the best and brightest liberal arts and sciences undergraduates from 286 top schools across the nation. Of the 44 presidents, 17 have been Phi Beta Kappa members. Bill Clinton, George H.W. Bush, and Jimmy Carter were the most recent. Dr. Perry puts forward, among others, Herbert Hoover, a very, very bright scientist, a geologist, Woodrow Wilson, our only PhD president, and William H. Taft, a brilliant lawyer. And, although a president's IQ has never been confirmed, in 2006, the University of California estimated that John Quincy Adams was the most intelligent of all presidents. Dr. Perry also says some presidents have undeserved reputations. Gerald Ford was viewed as being a klutz, because he would trip in public, but that was so unfair. He had an undergraduate degree from the University of Michigan, where he was from, he was an Eagle Scout, he went to Yale Law School, and he was a star footballer on top of that. She also says that intelligence is only part of what makes a good president. It was the Supreme Court Justice Oliver Wendell Holmes, who famously said Franklin Delano Roosevelt had a second-class intellect but a first-class temperament. Roosevelt was re-elected in 36 by two-thirds of the electorate. I would put Warren Harding in that category, says Dr. Perry. He was a journalist by training. This is awkward. Some of my best friends are journalists, says Dr. Perry, laughing.